Welcome back to another video. If you're new to my channel, welcome. For this video, I'm going to be doing a super cute pink butterfly nail design, and I'm starting off with some peel off base coat because I'm doing the apres method and I'm not going to be wearing these nails for long. So I'm just going to put on a thin coat of that on each nail and let that dry, and then I'll go in with the rest of the process. But I'm going to be using some products from the Macart Ocean Couture Nail Kit, and then I'm also going to be using some Macart Blooming Gel. So as always, everything that I'm using will be linked in the description box down below if you're interested, and then I'll also have my coupon code down there. But this is the glitter that I'm using, a super cute pink glitter, and then I'm going to be using one of those dried flowers. Starting off with the ring finger, and I'm just going in with a layer of base coat gel, and then before I cure that in the lamp, I'm going to go in with some of that glitter. I'm just going to put it all throughout the nail, and then I'm just going to place it in the lamp to flash cure it. I wanted to go ahead and say thank you so much to Naj K for your comment on my previous video. Hopefully I pronounced that right, but I just wanted to say that I really love when people tell me that I encourage them to go ahead and start their YouTube channel or to continue posting on their YouTube channel. I would say that you can look at other people and see their channel growing or see their designs and feel kind of discouraged. But don't be discouraged or don't feel like your designs aren't good enough to post. Just try your best and continue to be consistent and your channel will definitely grow. So yeah, I really appreciate your comment and thank you so much for watching my videos. While that's curing in the lamp, I'm going in with a layer of base coat gel on my pinky, and then I'm just going to put some inside of the full cover nail tip, press it on, and then hold it in front of the lamp to flash cure it. Now I'm just going to repeat those same steps with the ring finger that I just took out of the lamp. And I can say that for this nail, it really didn't lay as flat as I would have wanted it to. When putting glitter inside of a full cover nail tip, you want to make sure that you just put the smaller glitters towards the cuticle area, and then you can do larger ones around the tip. Because if you put bigger ones around the cuticle area, then it just makes it a little bit more difficult for it to press down fully. But I'm just going on to the middle finger, and I'm putting some base coat gel inside of the nail, and then I'm going in with the dried flower. So I just place that in, and then I'm just using the end of like a nail brush to just hold that into place, and then I just cured that in the lamp. Now I'm going over it with another layer of base coat gel because I decided to put another little piece at the tip of the nail. So I'm just going to hold that down also and flash cure it in the lamp, and then I'll just file away any extra that's hanging over. And once that's cured, I'm going in with a third coat of base coat gel, and this one is to apply the glitter. I really wanted the flower to show up a little bit more, so I wish I didn't put as much glitter around it as I did, but overall this nail still turned out cute. Now I'm just going to go in and apply the remaining nails using the same method. Now that those are on and fully cured, I'm going to go in with some of this Born Pretty Gel Polish in the shade SP02. And I'm putting that on the pinky and pointer finger because I'm going to be doing a French tip design on those nails. And I want this to be my natural nail bed color. So I'll put one coat and cured it in the lamp, and now I'm going in with a second coat. Once that second coat is cured, I'm wiping away the sticky layer, and then I'm going to go in with some French tip tape. kind of out of frame when I was doing this part, but I just went in with 2 coats of white gel polish above the French tip tape so that I could do my French. This is how it turned out. Not the best, but it's okay. Now I'm going to go in with some of this McCart Blooming Gel in the pink shade or fuchsia, and I'm just going to go in and just kind of dab that on the nail. Also, I know sometimes when people use blooming gel, they'll go in with a small brush and some alcohol and kind of customize the design, but I decided not to. I like the way it looked as is, so I just left it that way. Now I'm just going to seal that using some top coat gel, and then I'm also going to be placing my butterfly decals into that top coat gel and my rhinestones. So I'm not going to cure this just yet. I'm just going to put the decals under some water so that they can slide right off of the paper, and then I'm just placing them on the nail. And then once I do this, I'm going to go on to do my design on the thumb, and then I'll come back to the pointer and pinky to apply my rhinestones. For the thumb, I'm doing a marble design, and I'm just going to go in with some base coat gel, and then before I cure that in the lamp, I'm going to go in with some of this white gel polish, and I'm just going to kind of spread it out, and then I'm going to go behind that with some of the blooming gel, and I plan on putting matte top coat over this. I just love the way that marble looks matte, so I'm going to go in with that once I'm done with the design. Now I'm going back to the pointer and pinky, and I'm just using some of these rhinestones from the McCart Ocean Couture Nail Kit, and I'm just placing the rhinestones along that smile line so that I can kind of cover them up. But again, I kept going kind of out of frame, so I just had to speed it up and cut out some parts. But I'm using the stones that aren't the AB stones. They're just kind of silver, and I don't typically get these type of stones, but since I got those in the kit, I decided to go ahead and use them, and I actually really like the way they look. But now that I'm done, I'm just going in with the top coat. So again, I'm doing matte on the thumb, and then I'm just putting some clear on top of those glitter nails, and then the pointer and pinky already have top coat on them. But that's pretty much it for this nail design. So I hope that you all enjoyed the video. If you did, be sure to give it a thumbs up, leave a comment down below, and subscribe to my channel so that you don't miss out on any of my upcoming videos. Bye.